Michel Marnay, the French heart crusher, sailed incog tonight from Naples on board the Napoli. Why? Because Lois Clark and her 20 million smackers will be at the dock palpitating for him. And it's good news for us mere men, because when he arrives, Michel Marnay goes out of circulation. This time, it's marriage.
Voici une nouvelle sensationnelle qui va briser bien des corps. Michel Marnay, le célèbre sportsman, s'embarque ce soir. Oui.
Well, here we are, ladies and gentlemen. And a nice, crisp little titbit has just come in. Oh, by the way, I might mention I'm speaking from dear old London, as usual. Well, it's rumored that Michel Marnay sails for America tonight to enter into matrimony, at last, with one of America's industrial nobility, Louise Clark, the rock and gravel heiress, stone and sand, you know. Well, that seems to be all. Good night.
Signor Marnay? No. Signor Marnay? Signor Marnay?
No. Is he on board?
Signor Marnay? Signor Marnay? Signor Marnay? Signor Marnay? Signor Marnay? Signor Marnay?
Mr. Marnay, will you autograph this picture of you? Please. Write something we can always remember.
Something sizzling.
Thank you.
It's in French. Isn't it wonderful? I wonder what it means.
You are very lovely girls, but you have very bad manners.
Pardon, madame. Je crois que vous lisez mon télégramme.
I beg your pardon?
I say I believe you're reading my radiogram.
Ah. Oh. Just a moment. Well, how do I know it's yours? Can you identify yourself?
Well, I am Michel Marnay.
Oh, don't tell me you're the fella. Well, this is pretty personal. Can you tell me what it says?
Well, it says, remembering a warm, beautiful night, a thunderstorm over Lake Como, and you.
And you. It's you. Oh. That's all right, huh?
Mm-hmm. It was nice.
Do you think it'll ever take the place of baseball? Did you lose it again?
Look. I'm in trouble. Serious trouble.
Well, I could have told you playing around Lake Como. The poor thing.
I must talk to someone.
Well, I'm really not very good about that sort of thing. I talk a lot. I've tried to break myself of the habit.
You have an honest face.
Oh, you...
I can trust you, can't I?
Yes, I guess so.
Come with me.
But look, the captain has an honest face, too. And the purser, I thought he had a very honest...
Uh,
Shall we go to your cabin or mine?
Mine.
Well, maybe mine is closer.
Mine is here.
Oh.
Not that I'm prudish. It's just that my mother told me never to enter a man's room in any months ending an R.
Your mother must be a very beautiful woman. What's your name?
Terry McCarey. Terry McCarey, and I'm traveling alone. That wasn't by any chance what was troubling you, was it?
Yes.
Oh, this is fine.
I thought you'd like it.
You saved my life, you know. I was bored to tears. I haven't seen one attractive girl on this boat since we left. Can you imagine?
9 days like that? Oh, this is terrible.
That's not for me.
I should be bright. Should be beautiful and bubbling like pink champagne. I got scared. I said to myself, don't beautiful women travel anymore? Evidently not. Then I saw you and it was all right. I was saved. I hope. Cigarette?
Oh, thank you. Have you been getting results with a line like that? Or would I be surprised?
But if you were surprised, that would surprise me.
It sounds like a nasty crack. I could make a few, too, if I felt like it.
I'm sure you could.
I know I can.
That's what I said.
I think I will. How's your fiancé?
She's got a cold.
Oh, that's too bad. Is that at Lake Como?
No, she wasn't there.
Oh, you mean the lady of the lake was not...
That was her best friend.
Oh. Chummy bunch.
Yeah. Oh, this boat is going awfully fast. Only 8.5 days till we get in. Is there any reason why, from now on, it shouldn't be pink champagne? Don't tell me he's the fellow. He's all right, huh? He's nice. Where is he now?
Well, he's visiting his parents. He sends me on a buying trip every once in a while. You see, he's my boss, too.
You don't think he would approve of pink champagne, do
you?
Oh,
no, I don't.
Well, I think it's very touching, you and him. Very beautiful. I like that.
Oh, glad.
He must be a very fascinating fellow.
Well, you can just imagine how attractive he is when I can resist so charming a person as you.
Yes. I think I'll go now. After all, I still have deck tennis and kino, and there is always shuffleboard.
Don't tell me you're embarrassed.
Oh, yes. Yes, I am. So if you don't mind, I think I'll take my pride for a walk. Unless by chance you care to have dinner with a...
Oh, I'd love that. Right. Oh, that would be very nice. Instead of Mother Goose, you were probably brought up on the memoirs of Casanova.
Not at all.
But you've heard of the little fellow, haven't you? Imagine you've known quite a few women, haven't you? Or maybe few is the wrong word. And I gather you haven't very much respect for them. But you've always been very fair in your judgment.
I beg pardon, Signora. Would you like me to reserve this table for you every night?
Why not? You know,
Look, let's talk about you now.
Oh, no, not tonight. Let's talk about me some other night.
All right.
Signor Marnay.
Another one.
And your name, please?
Okay.
Ah. Where were we? Oh, yes. What's the name of that
Strange place you came from?
Kansas.
And from there?
Well, then I went to New York and got a job singing in a nightclub from 10 to 3 in the morning, and then the manager used to chase me around his office till about 4, and then I went home. And then one night, he came along.
Oh, yes.
He said I didn't belong in a place like that. He said that,
I didn't say anything.
He said that,
that you should improve yourself.
Yeah. So I studied hard.
So that someday you would be a charming and lovely wife.
Yeah, that was the idea. Is there anything wrong with that?
Oh, no, no, no.
Well, that's what I thought. But nothing happened. Well, it just about brings us up to date. Now my life's an open book.
It's only one page.
It's the only page.
I beg your pardon. Grazie. Thank you very much.
Oh, that's bad.
It's a beautiful camera you've got.
Oh, there. Yes.
Takes very clear
pictures. Oh, very good. Please, monsieur.
Look, I guess it isn't any good for either one of us to be seen together. Right or wrong, you know, people like to talk. Better be goodbye.
What's the matter? Afraid?
Of you? No.
Well, after all, we're on the same ship. Still have 8 days, you know.
Well, you can take nice long walks out in the sunshine.
What should I do if it rains?
Yeah, it's no good.
I see. It's particularly no good for you.
Yes, that's right. Being seen with you is news, and I don't want to get my picture in the paper. So, I think we better spread out.
Hey, get me down from here, will you? I got up there and I couldn't get back.
Can you do that?
Sure.
Good, you're quite a fellow.
Hey, you must be quite a guy yourself.
Yes, why?
Well, everybody on the ship's talking about you.
No, what do they say about me?
Well, I don't know, on the contrary, every time they start talking about you, they make me leave the room.
Is that so?
Ooh, be careful there, Sonny. You'll fall and hurt yourself. When I was little like you, I fell and broke my leg.
How's it now?
It's all right.
And what are you crabbing about?
Well, I'm not crabbing. I just thought that you... I'm sorry.
Give me a champagne cocktail, will you?
Yes, sir.
Got cigarettes?
At the cigarette stand, sir.
The pink champagne?
Yes.
Champagne cocktail, please.
Yes, madam.
Have you anything, champagne?
Yes.
I changed my table to a table for one.
So did I.
It's too bad it had to be like that. We had such a delightful dinner last night. And
parlez-vous in paix, Athelé?
What's
fooling the world. Everybody's watching us. This is awful.
Going my way?
Calling on a lady.
Oh, even in Madeira?
No, you're wrong this time. My grandmother.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's all right. She lives up on the hill. Would you like to meet her?
Yes, I'd be very happy to. Come on, get in.
She must be in the chapel.
Hello, Jack. Still in the room?
What is there about this place? There's something makes you feel you ought to whisper. Peace. It's like another world.
My grandmother's world.
Tell me a little more about her.
My grandfather was in the diplomatic service. They lived all over the world. This was his last post. He died here. So she stayed on to be near him. He's buried there near the chapel. She must be waiting, I think a little impatiently, for the day she will join him.
Michel, mon chéri. Pourquoi ne m'as-tu pas annoncé ton arrivée?
Mais tu me connais, tu sais bien que je me décide toujours au dernier moment. Et puis, je voulais faire une surprise.
Tu vas vraiment te marier?
Oui, oui, enfin, pareil. Je ne suis pas très sûr encore du tout. Laisse-moi te regarder. Regardez-moi ça, mais tu es rajeuni. De 10 ans, hein? Et c'est chaque fois la même chose. Alors, chaque fois que je reviens, je trouve plus jeune. Comment fais-tu, ça? Hein? Comment fais-tu?
C'est elle?
Hein? Oh, non, non, non. May I present Miss Terry McKay. She thought you were the girl I'm going to marry.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Elle est charmante. Elle me plaît beaucoup.
Oh, pardon. I was only saying I liked you very much.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad.
If you'll excuse me, I'll sit down for a moment. I'm longer with my prayers these days, and my knees, well, they are as old as I am. Are you English? No, I'm an American.
American? Do you know, my dear, I have a special fondness for America. It was my husband's first post after we married.
Really?
In fact, we went to Washington on our honeymoon.
You have a lovely place here.
Thank you.
I like to stay on forever.
You are too young for that. It's a good place to sit and remember, but you still have to create your memories. Would you like to go inside the chapel?
May I?
How long has it been for you, Michelle?
Since
you were an altar boy.
A
Then you better go in, too. It won't hurt you. I'll prepare tea.
Good.
Never seen such lovely colors.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's so vivid.
Yes.
Even the green seems greener.
Yes, they get a lot of rainfall here.
Who takes care of this place?
Hmm? Oh, an old gardener over there. There he is.
Oh, monsieur. Well. On est content de vous voir, vous savez.
Moi aussi, mon vieux. C'est une nouvelle?
Oui, monsieur. L'étanière.
Combien as-tu depuis que je t'ai pas vu?
Trois.
Oh. He's got three children, since I have seen him.
Well, Emile says France needs men, so he has seven daughters.
Seven?
Well, if you'd excuse me, I think I'm going to see the rest of the family.
Elle est toute dans la maison, monsieur. Dans la maison?
Oh, qu'est-ce que c'est que ça? Tu n'as que des filles?
Tea will be ready any moment.
May I help you?
Thank you, my dear. Oh,
where are your cups?
In there.
Oh, thank you. I'm sorry. I had to let my maid go. I have to watch my expenses. You see, I planned on dying when I was 75. And here I am, 77. So if I am not going to die, I have to start saving my money. You like it?
Yes, it's charming. Who did that?
Michel.
Michel?
He painted it for me.
Why, it's good.
He's very talented.
Oh, forgive me. You see, I wouldn't have any way of knowing.
Unfortunately, he is also very critical. As a result, he hasn't done anything since.
What a pity.
Besides, Michel is too busy...
living?
Thank you. Things come too easy to him, and he's always hallooed by the art he's not practicing, the places he hasn't been, the girl he hasn't met. I don't mind confessing to you, my dear, that I've been worried about him.
Why?
That one day life will present a bill to Michel, and that he will find it hard to pay. But when I see him with you, I feel better.
I don't understand. He's going to be married and settled down. And can't you just see him with his slippers and his pipe?
No. There is many a slip betwixt the lip and the altar. and anything could happen on a boat. Believe me, my dear, there is nothing wrong with Michelle that a good woman could not make right.
Well, I saw Emile's entire family, 7 daughters. I congratulated him, and I had a nice talk with his wife. How have you two girls been getting along?
Mm-hmm. You'd be surprised.
I bet she did all the talking.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. She told me that when you were a little boy, if you didn't get your own way, you used to lie on the floor and kick and get red in the face.
And what did you say?
Well, I said you didn't do that anymore. Now, if you don't get your own way, you just get embarrassed.
What have you two been discussing? It seems a lot has been going on that I know nothing about. Well, I'm afraid we must be going.
Michel.
See? Janou, you must play the piano for us before we go. She was a great pianist, you know.
Come on.
She's going to play right now.
But Michel, look at my hands. Remember, I was asked to do this. I don't like boat whistles.
I know.
Here. Better have this round you.
Thank you.
Isn't it beautiful?
You like it?
I do.
I'll send it to you someday. This is as far as I can go.
This is the boundary of my small world.
It's a perfect world. Thank you for letting me trespass. Bye.
God bless you.
Well, Janu, I'll come back to see you very soon. Really, I will. And I shall write very often. You'll see.
Please do.
Like stormy weather ahead.
We've changed our course today. I want to thank you for a lovely evening.
I want to thank you for what was undoubtedly the loveliest day I've ever known.
You've been very sweet to my little grandmother.
I'm going to write to her.
Oh, that'll be nice. Well, good night.
We're heading into a rough sea, Michelle. Good night. For your thoughts, I'll jump overboard.
I thought you'd gone to bed.
What good would that do? I can't sleep.
Yes, I know. All I seem to do is turn, toss.
Dreaming?
I wouldn't call that dreaming. I'm awake. I'd call it wishing.
My father used to say, wishes are the dreams we dream when we're awake.
Your father said?
He drank a lot.
I wrote a song once about wishing. That's nice.
Oh, why?
No, I didn't. I mean, it was.
It was not bad.
You know, one day I'm going to learn your language and be very funny, too.
I'm sorry. How does it go?
Oh, I forget. But it meant, if you wish very hard with your mind, and if you wish very strong in your heart, and if you keep on wishing long enough and strong enough.
You get what you want for Christmas?
Yes. Well, we get in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Will he be waiting?
And she?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I suppose if we have something in our minds, we better say it now.
Yes.
You know, I've never worked in all my life
In all my life, I've never worked.
I've been thinking about that. What'd you say?
I didn't say anything.
You did too. You said I was very fond of expensive things, furs and jewels and things.
Did I say that?
I guess you and I have been more or less used to a life of pink champagne. Maybe it'd be a little difficult to... You like beer?
Yes, I do, but...
Oh, no. It's bad for the figure. My father used to say, it's a funny thing, but the things we like best are either illegal, immoral, or fattening. I told you, he drank like a pig.
I wonder what your father would think of me. Never working.
Not once.
Well, just because you haven't...
Oh, I didn't mean that I couldn't. I know, of course not. But I couldn't find out all at once. It would take me, oh, at least 6 months to find out if...
If what?
Well, it's hard to say. After all, it's unfair to ask you to take a chance. But if I work hard enough and long enough, and if wishes came true, where would you be?
What are you trying to say, Michelle?
I'm trying to say that it would take me 6 months to find out if I'm worthy to say what's in my heart.
Oh, that's just about the nicest thing. I think I'll turn in, do a little more rolling and tossing. I'll think it over and let you know in the morning. Going my way?
No, I think I'll walk a little.
Marriage is a very serious step for a girl like me.
Yes, I know.
You like children?
Oh, yes, I do. I was so worried.
I'm sorry.
What...
I didn't even know we were in. I'm only half dressed. Look, if everything turns out all right, for both of us, I mean, in 6 months.
Yes.
That's July.
July, yes.
I've written out these directions. Read them carefully so there won't be any mistake.
Darling, that's me. July 1st, 5 o'clock, 102nd floor, top of the Empire State Building.
Yes. That's it right there. It's the tallest building in the world. You can't miss that.
No.
It's the nearest thing to heaven we have in New York. Be sure you take the elevator. Well, until we meet again, take care of yourself.
morning. Have you seen some of the press?
Michael.
So glad to see you.
Oh, I'm so glad to see you. Did you have a nice crossing?
Yes, I had a very nice crossing.
Miss Clark.
Yes.
Call it for still, please.
Yes.
Thank you. Now, just one more, please.
Oh, yes.
That's fine. Now, just one more, Miss Clark, please. One more.
Did you get it, Ralph?
Will this do?
Oh, that's fine. That's fine, Miss Clark. Thank you.
Sorry,
I just one more.
You'll excuse me. I have an appointment.
Oh, Michael, I'm so glad you're back. Let me look. Oh, it's wonderful to have you back. Rough crossing?
Well, you wouldn't exactly call it smooth.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Oh, excuse us. Sorry, darling. It's great to have you back.
Well, it's great to be back, Ken. Yeah.
Arrived. Where's the keys?
Don't unpack, Annie. I'm moving.
Well, lots of good luck.
Thanks.
I hope you'll be working here. The terms are satisfactory, but as I said before...
I know. It's not up to you. It's up to the customer.
That's right. You sing, then we'll talk further.
And if I can't find you, I'll understand.
That's right.
Is applause, isn't it?
Oh, well, maybe they're applauding your $2 dinner.
I'd like to talk a long contract.
6 months?
That's not a long time.
Oh, yes, it is. Go on and dance, my heart. This is romance, my heart. So keep pretending. Happy ending. If it's to be, we soon shall see. And if it's not to be, no power on earth can make it so. You know it's me, my heart. Go on and
nice, but you are my nicest boarder.
Well, no matter what you say, I'm not going to pay you a cent more.
Oh, who wants more money? I'm so happy you are here.
You're always happy. What's the secret?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. My place is half empty. I have rheumatism, and my husband left me with 5 children, and they are all ashamed of me.
I'm sorry.
Oh, you shouldn't be sorry. You should be happy. There is no boyfriends calling on you, so you don't get married. And if you don't get married, your children won't be ashamed of you. Well, good night. Don't you read late, because it's bad for your eyes. Good night. I'm not going to worry about anything. Oh, you know, I joke a lot about marriage, but it can be a beautiful thing. You know, you should get married if you find the right man. Well, of course, I don't know where you will find him, of course, but don't you marry a loafer like I did. It's just as easy to marry a man with lots of money. Maybe you don't love him at first, but you can teach yourself in 6 easy lessons. Just don't you marry a loafer. I married one. He was a prize winner.
I was hoping you would like one of...
Well, I suppose if I can't sell my paintings, I'll get a job.
Well, I won't give up painting. Why, painting
is... I'm not going to give it up.
This is the only thing I know. But I've got to make money. A lot of money.
Of course.
Well, in order to make money, you must eat.
Even the new money gets hungry, you know.
Michel! Michel!
Oh.
I have good news for you.
What?
I sold one.
Which one?
The woman. I got $100 for her.
What are you so happy about?
I'm a painter.
So am I. But I ain't happy.
Welcome home.
Thank you.
How well you're looking.
Yes, I know. I didn't get it here.
Where have you been all these months?
Out of town.
Oh, my dear, we've missed you.
Well, I've missed you too, Miss...
Lane.
Miss Lane, I want to get something so beautiful.
simple, you understand, but breathtaking.
Oh, of course. Miss Webb, look who's back.
Oh, Miss McCarey. Dear. Well, we were just saying, whatever happened to Miss McCarey? And here you are.
Oh, isn't it wonderful?
Miss McCarey is here, and we were just wondering.
Miss McCarey is there? Well, give her anything in the shop, but hold her till I get there, will you? You weren't worried about her credit, were you?
Yes. Yes, that's what we were wondering. I knew you'd understand, Mr. Bradley. Thank you so much.
I don't think you could make a mistake on either one. Oh, excuse me, please.
Where should we have this sent?
Well, I don't know at the moment. I'll have to call back and let you know. I think that's right, isn't it?
No charge?
No.
Oh, goodbye, Miss McCarey.
Do come back again soon.
Yes, don't stay away so long, my dear.
Thank you. Goodbye, Miss Webb.
Goodbye,
Miss Lane.
Terry.
Ken, what are you doing here? How on earth did you know I was here?
Oh, I see. What time is it, Ken? I'm late.
5 minutes to five.
It's good to see you again.
It's wonderful to see you again. I've got so much to talk to you about. Can't we go someplace now?
Oh, no, I'm in a hurry.
But I've got so much to say.
Well, call me up sometime. No, you can't do that either, can you, when I'm going to be married?
Oh, then you are going to...
Yes, Ken, and I'm late. What time did you say it was?
4 minutes to five. It looks like I came all the way down here just to tell you what time it was.
Yes. Goodbye, Ken.
Goodbye. Good luck.
Thanks. You can imagine how excited I am. I thought 34th Street was that way, and it's down here.
I'll save time if I get out here. I'm in a hurry. There you are.
What's the rush?
I'm going to be married, and I'd like you to be the first to congratulate me. Thank you so much.
Down?
No.
Going down?
No. Hey, what time are you good?
5. Doctor. What do you think?
Her x-rays aren't very encouraging. It's hard to say if she'll ever walk again. We can tell better in about 6 months. Are you the fellow she was yelling about under the anesthetic?
No, that's another chap. She was on her way to marry him.
Has he been notified?
No, she doesn't want that. Because, till she knows what you say you won't know for 6 months, she'd rather he didn't know.
That's being sensible. Nice girl.
I think so. Excuse me.
Well, we weren't sure whether or not we'd have you with us today.
Oh, this is the man. You know.
Yes, he explained.
Then you know, I was on my way to be married. While I was on my way to be a good girl, I got hit right in the intersection of 34th and 5th. Wasn't anybody's fault but my own. I had an appointment way up. I didn't want to keep him waiting. Oh, it could have been beautiful. Marriage, I mean. Children. Forgive me, Father. I'm a little weak. I don't get out of exercise.
Danu? Danu?
Monsieur Michel, she gave me this to send to you. I was going to mail it today. She said it was for the young lady that was here with you.
you, Pastor Jane?
Fine. She's got on a red flannel petticoat.
Oh. Well, it's warm, eh?
Oh, there it is. Been practicing your song?
Mm-hmm.
Know your parts today?
Mm-hmm. Sure. I knew mine yesterday.
Is that well, so?
Oh, come on, come on. Well, let's try it. I've been practicing, too. Wait till you hear me. One, two.
Wishing will make it so. Just keep on wishing, and care will go. Dreamers tell us dreams come true. It's no mistake, and wishes are the dreams we dream when we're awake. The curtain of night will part if you are certain within your heart. So if you wish long enough, wish strong enough, you will come to know.
One, two.
Wishing will make it so. Just keep on wishing, and care will go. Dreamers tell
Get
us
her.
Dreams
go.
How long has this been going on?
Only a few days. I hope you're not angry.
Oh, no, no. But when you have as many youngsters on your hands as I have, you have a problem.
Oh, I don't know. I like them.
I do, too. But they don't like me. They call me Picklepuss. At heart, they're just little savages. But music, you know, has charms to soothe a savage breast. And if it has such an influence, and if you can do so much in a few days, I'm thinking...
I wonder if you're thinking the same thing I am. Music has charms, and I like children, and children like me, and... I'll be getting out of here pretty soon. When I do, I'll be needing a job badly.
It will be only an experiment, you understand?
Yes, I know.
We can't pay a high...
Oh, I know, I know. Just so you'll pay me enough that I don't go around calling you Picklepuss.
I'd like to give them a surprise. So if you don't say anything, I won't say anything.
I won't say a word.
We won't tell anybody when we get the big house tomorrow.
I must say you've become a better painter, my friend. Maybe you've become a better critic. 6 months of hard work. Well, I'm glad you haven't wasted your time, my friend. I've sold everything but this. I told him to take it out of the window since you telephoned to me.
Thanks.
This is the best, I think.
Yes. I'm not exactly ashamed of it myself.
But you don't want to sell it, eh?
No, I don't want to sell it. I wouldn't mind getting rid of it, but somehow I don't want to take money for it.
Oh. I thought maybe you were keeping it because you were nursing a broken heart, eh?
No. Broken heart is not for me. Life is what you make it, Kobe. From now on, I'm taking my fun where I find it.
Oh.
Well, I'll be seeing you soon again.
Mm-hmm. Merry Christmas, Kobe.
Merry Christmas to you, my friend.
Michael. I heard you were in town. I've had a terrible time running you down.
Ah, you've been gone a long time, mon ami. And I've been thinking of you morning, noon, and night, and in between times. What? Why, I know you've been busy, but you could make the theater tonight, couldn't you? Well, I'll leave a ticket at your hotel.
Where shall we go from here?
Why, Michael, that's up to you. After all, this is your evening.
Well, I don't know where to go anymore. I just came back, you know.
Let me tell him. No. I'll go get him.
No.
It's tough. The first time you're able to get out, you have to meet him.
All I could say was, hello. Show's over. The boy got the girl. Shall we go?
Seems terrible taking you home with everybody going out. I'm going to ask you once more. Why don't you let me help you?
And I'm going to tell you once more. If I let you finance my getting well, he wouldn't like it. And if he wouldn't like it, I wouldn't like it. And if you did get me well and I went to him, you wouldn't like it.
Well, then certainly he ought to know.
No, because if he found out, he'd want to do something about it. And then if I didn't get well, he wouldn't like it and I wouldn't like it and you wouldn't like it. It would be awful. No. Unless I can walk to him one day and... When I say walk, I mean run. He'll never know. But I've got my job now, and I'm on a budget, and if everything works out all right, and I'm a good little girl, maybe I'll get what I want next Christmas.
Well, thank you, Reyes. Good night.
Are you sure you don't want to come with us? The evening is so young and everything.
No, I think I'll turn him. Some other time. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Taking you to the theater wasn't a very good idea, was it, Michael?
No. Merry Christmas, Grace.
Merry Christmas, Michael.
Thank you.
What's the matter, buddy? Feeling sorry for yourself?
Yeah.
You don't know what troubles are. Look at me. I live at 186th Street, and they won't let me on the subway.
She's not feeling very well.
Oh, that's too bad.
But she wants to see you. Go on.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Good
morning.
Good morning, Miss Kay.
Hello. Hello. I have bad news for you. Doctor says I can't go.
Oh. Bye.
Look, Doctor, I could be back in a couple of hours. This is a Christmas benefit. It's our first public appearance. This is my team.
She's our coach, Doc.
Doctor.
Doctor.
If it was going to hurt her, you wouldn't want her to go, would you?
No.
You really don't need the piano. Come on, go through it once without me. The only place you might get stuck is right at the beginning, and Aloysius can sing an A in his sleep, can't you, Al?
Sure.
Come on, let's hear it.
Oh.
See? Now, ready. One, two. Where's Patsy Jane?
She's got a sore throat, and she won't be able to go on the stage.
Oh, come here, darling. Pretty new dress, too. You really want to go on the stage? Well, then I tell you what you do. You go right along with the rest of them, and you pretend to sing. You know, make believe, like this. They'll never know the difference.
Thank you, Miss McCarey.
You're welcome. Now, come on, pitch pipe. Give.
Oh.
One, two. No, not too loud. There's a baby upstairs. One, two.
Just keep on wishing, and care will go. Dreamers tell us dreams come true. It's no mistake, then the wishes are the dreams we
of a Christmas for you, is it?
No, I guess not. Oh, wait.
Are you comfortable?
Yes, I'm all right. Mm-hmm.
Well, if you want anything, you just call.
I will. Michelle.
Hello. How are you, T?
Good to see you.
Yes, it's good to see you, too. Feeling all right?
Oh, yes, I'm fine. I'm just resting. Ah. It's been a long time.
Yes. Yes, that's right.
Good to see you.
Yes, you said that. May I?
Oh, if you sit down.
Thank you. I'll be only a minute. You're sure you don't mind? I
bet you're wondering how I got here.
I was looking in the telephone book for a man named McBride when I saw the name of Terry McKay. So I said to myself, could that be Terry McKay, my old friend?
And it was.
Yes. Then I said to myself, I haven't been very nice to Miss McKay. After all, I had an appointment with her one day at... And I didn't keep it. That wasn't a very nice way to treat an old friend, was it?
No.
So I said to myself, I must apologize. And here I am.
That's sweet of you.
Yes, I think so.
I often wondered about you, how you were.
Oh, you did? Really? Well, I often wondered about you, too. So, you didn't get angry because I wasn't there?
What do you think?
Oh, you must have been at first.
Oh, yes, yeah, that's what I thought. I was. Mm. At first, I was furious. I said, he can't do a thing like this to me. Who does he think he is?
And how long did you, I mean, did you wait long?
Well, let's see, I waited until about...
midnight?
Oh.
And then what did you do?
Well, then I was really mad. You can just imagine up there.
In a thunderstorm?
Yes.
And then what did you say to yourself?
Well, then I said, why don't you go home and get tight?
You didn't do that.
Didn't I?
Maybe you took a little one every hour for about a month.
Can you blame me?
I should say not. The least I could have done was to send you a note.
Well, maybe when you thought about it, you didn't know where to reach me.
But you swore that if you ever saw me again, you'd ask. You didn't?
No. No, I remembered. We said if we could make it, we'd be there. And if one of us didn't show up, there must have been a darn good reason.
But what, for instance?
And the other one shouldn't ask questions. Asking questions is... life must be bright. We must keep it beautiful and bubbling like pink champagne. So there'll be no questions asked. I hope. Cigarette?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Think of me walking all the way up here, 10 blocks to... and instead, I promised not even to ask you why you didn't show up. You knew I was going to. Doesn't seem fair somehow.
I know.
I don't know what it is. But when I'm with you, I... well... no wedding ring?
No.
Well, I thought when I saw you at the...
at the theater last night? No, he was... no.
I didn't mean to offend you.
How's everything with you, Michelle?
Oh, so you can ask questions.
Yeah.
Well, I thought everything was fine until I saw you last night. Then I knew there must be something between us. Even if only a notion.
No.
So I bought myself a ticket.
Sailing?
Yes. Tonight. Yep. Well. You're happy, aren't you?
you?
Well, I don't know. I'm worried about the future. What people will think of me. They'll say, there he goes, the mad painter. There must be something the matter with him. He doesn't like women.
You mean he won't even speak to them?
Oh, yes, yes. He sails the seven seas. And to every woman he meets, he says, where will you be in 6 months?
And they're there.
Everywhere. Eiffel Tower, pyramids, everywhere, waiting.
But he doesn't. Where is he?
Waiting. Oh. You want to change the subject?
Mm-hmm. Merry Christmas.
Oh, I almost forgot. Well, 6 months ago, who would have thought we'd spend Christmas together? By the way, I have a present for you.
Present? Oh, I wish I had something for you.
Well, you didn't know I was going to. Anyway, it's not really a Christmas present. Oh.
So that's why my letters came back.
She wanted you to have it. Remember?
Yes, I remember.
I would have sent it to you, only I didn't know your address until today, so. Goodbye, Terry.
Goodbye, Michelle.
You like that, with a shawl. I wish you'd seen it. Kobe says he's my dealer. He says it's the best thing I've done. I didn't think I would ever part with it, but there was no reason for keeping it anymore. And then he told me about a girl who came into his shop. He told me she liked it very much. I suppose she saw in it, well, what I hoped you'd see. So I told him to give it to her. Because he said she was poor, and not only that, he told me that you... He told... He said...
Yeah?
Anyway, I told him to give it to her. Yes. She couldn't afford it, and it was Christmas season. You know me, big-hearted Michelle.
What time did your boat sail?
Boat? Why didn't you tell me, Terry?
Darling.
If anything had to happen to one of us, why did it have to be you?
Oh, don't look at me like that. It wasn't anybody's fault but my own. I was looking up at the 102nd floor.
It was the nearest thing to heaven. You see, you were there. Oh. Don't worry. It doesn't have to be a miracle. If you can paint, I can walk. Anything can happen, don't you think?
Yes, I think so.